The key property of a stem cell is that it has the ability to make copies of itself, remain as an undifferentiated stem cell, but at the same time, bud off specialized differentiated cells. So we can think of stem cells as being a sort of pool of cells that have the capacity to regenerate tissues. Some stem cells are very specialized. So the first stem cells identified by Till and McCullough, the hematopoietic stem cells, have the capacity to make all the different cell types of our blood, but they don't make muscle, they don't make nerve, so they are restricted, or they're multipotent stem cells. Probably the most exciting stem cells are the ones we call pluripotent stem cells, which have the capacity to divide indefinitely, but have the capacity to make every cell type in our body. So these pluripotent stem cells have really been why stem cell research has undergone such a resurgence in the last few years. Induced pluripotent stem cells were first derived over 10 years ago now by Shinya Yamanaka in Japan. And what he showed was you could actually take adult skin cells, add a few genes and turn them right back to early development so they would behave like embryonic stem cells. This opened up major new pathways of research, and it also meant that we no longer had to use embryos to derive pluripotent stem cells. iPS cells, as well as being a source of cells for regenerative medicine, allow us also to study disease. We can make iPS cells from anybody, any patient with any disease, and begin to study that disease in the petri dish. So now we have several different kinds of stem cells to consider. Adult stem cells, like bone marrow stem cells, embryonic stem cells, and iPS cells. They all have uses, and they all have exciting potential. The differences between iPS cells and embryonic stem cells are really that the iPS cells have been reprogrammed back to early development. We still need to study embryonic stem cells because they are still the gold standard for understanding what pluripotency is and how to drive those cells to differentiate into the cell types we need for therapy. So there's a lot of excitement around the possibility of new therapies arising from our understanding about pluripotent stem cells. Because these cell types can make every cell type in our body, it opens up the possibility of new stem cell therapies for diseases like diabetes, Parkinson's, heart disease, muscular dystrophy, spinal cord repair, the list goes on. So this is the excitement of the future, but it's early days.